மரியாதைக்குரிய மத்திய அமைச்சர் திரு பொன்னு ராதாகிருஷ்ணன் அவர்களே, மீன்வளத்துறை அமைச்சர் ஸ்ரீ ஜெயக்குமார் அவர்களே, தமிழ மொழி மேம்பாட்டுத்துறை மற்றும் கலாச்சாரத்துறை அமைச்சர் ஓ பாண்டியராஜன் இது ஆப்ஷன்னா பல்கா லைக கலத்திஸ் நிறுவனர் மற்றும் அதிபர் கல்விக்கோ டாக்டர் ஜி விஸ்வநாதன் அவர்களே, குழுமத்தின் தலைவர் டாக்டர் ஜி வி ஜி சந்தோஷம் அவர்களே, திருமாப்போசியஸ் மகள் மிஸ்ஸஸ் மாதவி பாஸ்கரன் அவர்களே, திருமாப்போசியஸ் மருமகன் ஸ்ரீ கே டி பாஸ்கரன் அவர்களே, திருமாப்போசியஸ் பேரன் ஸ்ரீ பி செந்தில் அவர்களே, இன்றைய நிகழ்ச்சிக்கு வந்திருக்கும் அனைத்து தமிழ உலகுக்கும் வணக்கம். தமிழும் தமிழ்நாடும் என் மதருக்கு நெருக்கமானவை. இந்த மண்ணின் மைந்தர் ஸ்ரீ மா.போ.சியஸ் ஜெயந்தி விழாவில் கலந்து கொள்வதிலும் அனரை பற்றிய புத்தகத்தை வெளியிட்டும் இந்த நிகழ்ச்சியில் உங்களுடன் உரையாடுவதையும் நான் பெருமகிழ்ச்சி அடைகிறேன். My dear friends, I understand Tamil, but I can't speak you in Tamil. Tamil theriyum pesa mudiyadhu. I am happy to be with you all today for paying homage to an illustrious son of our country, Mylapore Ponnusamy Sivagnanam, fondly called as Ma.Po.Si. As we commemorate his 23rd anniversary, we recall the remarkable contribution he made to our nation as a freedom fighter, as a learned scholar of Tamil literature, and a great leader who forged a new identity for Tamil Nadu, Tamil language and Tamil culture. For Tamil Nadu, for Tamil language and Tamil culture, he did a yeoman service. It is indeed with great pleasure that I have accepted the invitation from his daughter to read the book on this great son of Tamil Nadu. In fact, many more books should have come about this great man. Thiru Ma.Po.Si avargal was a self-taught genius. Unable to complete his education because of poverty, he was so determined to acquire knowledge that he studied on his own and rose to great eminence as one of the foremost Tamil scholars of his time. He won several honorary doctoral degrees besides Sahitya Academy Award. He was a freedom fighter and an ardent follower of Mahatma Gandhi. Rajaji paid a glowing tribute to him for his leadership role in the freedom struggle. He said that he described his independence struggle in Tamil Nadu, Rajaji himself was the Arjuna, while Ma.Po.Si Sivagnanam was his philosopher, charioteer like Krishna. This is what Rajagopalacharya said. Ma.Po.Si was a true nationalist and a man who exemplified the best of Indian values. His principled stand in favor of prohibition antagonized several people of his own community in the 40s. He dared to stand alone and took a firm stand even if it meant crossing swords with the tall leaders like Periyar. He was a quite essential humanist who was opposed to caste discrimination. Ma.Po.Si was instrumental in formation of Tamil Nadu state with his major role in defining the topography of Tamil Nadu and christening it of the erstwhile Madras state as Tamil Nadu 50 years ago in 1968. We also remember Ma.Po.Si as an incisive researcher, a prolific writer, and a captivating orator. It was in Amaravati prison that Ma.Po.Si started his literary journey. His interest in Sangam literature was kindled by the words of Subramanya Bharati. He claimed that simple words of Bharati acted as a tutor to take him to the next literary level. He attributed all his literary growth to Subramanya Bharati, on whom he wrote about 10 research books. Ma.Po.Si had a great connect with the common man and woman. He wanted the classical literature to be accessible to everybody. Ma.Po.Si's title, Silambu Selvar, was conferred on him by Sri R.P. Sethu Pillai, not only because of his insightful research on the Tamil classic Silapati Karam, written by Ilango Adigal, but his untiring efforts to popularize it. A treasure trove of history to understand life 20 centuries ago in South India, Silapati Karam has an extraordinary literary flavor on par with other classics of the world. Ma.Po.Si dwelled into subtle nuances of the classic that dealt with the life of Kannagi and Kovalan, two ordinary persons who had extraordinary qualities. He is the one responsible to spread Silapati Karam to the length and breadth of Tamil Nadu. Even among the common man, he conducted the Silapati Karam visa in 1950 for the first time in Tamil history. From 1950 onwards, Ma.Po.Si Tamil Arasu Karam has been celebrating this festival every year. I am very happy that his daughter Madhavi Bhaskar has revived this tradition in 2013 through a trust run by her in the name of her father. Similarly, Ma.Po.Si wrote Kappala Tottiya Tamijam, a biography of E.O. Chidambaram Pillai that became very popular with the masses. This book was so popular that E.O. Chidambaram Pillai was subsequently remembered by all as Kappala Tottiya Tamijan. Ma.Po.Si was also instrumental in reviving the public interest in Sri Kattabomman. Sri Veerapandiya Kattabomman was a great personality of Tamil Nadu and also the country. Ma.Po.Si wrote his biography based on which a Tamil movie was made, for which Ma.Po.Si wrote the screenplay. Very powerful dialogue. I myself saw that picture and it is one of the best pictures that has been produced. And the cinema became popular because of the dialogues and the lyrics that are provided by Ma.Po.Si. He drew philosophical strength from the great saint of the 19th century, Ramalinga Adigal, popularly known as Valalar. His writings on Valalar and interpretation of the great saint's worldview remain unparalleled and won him the Sahitya Academy Award. Valalar himself got his inspiration from one of the greatest sages of India, Tirumular, who lived about 2000 years ago, inspiring Tamil poets and philosophers over the centuries. He propagated the idea of Ondre Kulam, Oruvane Devam. Humanity is one community, there is only one God. It is truth, Satyam. But to say it at that time, Ondre Kulam, Oruvane Devan, Vake Kulamu, Vake Devudu. Even in Telugu also we use the same word. Mana Manavali Anta Vakate, Kulamu Vakate, Manavali Anta Vakate. Ma.Po.Si was a great chronicler of events, not only the biographies of legendary figures he admired, but also of events that shaped India as we know today. Vidutthalai Poril Tamajagam is a great compilation by him in the role of Tamil Nadu in the nationalistic movement. It details the participation of Tamil Nadu people in freedom struggle that took place in the first half of the 20th century. It is an encyclopedia of nationalists hailing from the modern Tamil Nadu. He did a great service by collecting all this information and compiling about the great sacrifice made by those great patriots at that time and then placed it before the nation. Really, really it's a great work done by this great son of this great country. He was a staunch believer in the need to strengthen the traditional roots through extensive use of mother tongue and Indian languages. He loved Tamil language and culture and gave the clarion call that resonated in every Tamil home. Engam Tamil, Edulam Tamil, meaning Tamil everywhere, Tamil everything. Edulam Tamil, Tamil, Tamil Edulam, Engam Tamil, Edulam Tamil. That's a very great thing he said. This was not a mere slogan, but a reflection of his inner self. It gained tremendous popularity and is being echoed by every political party. I saw in the newspapers Mr. Thiru Viswanathan also starting a movement for popularizing Tamil. Tamil is one of the great, oldest, ancient, classical language. We should feel proud of our mother tongue. My dear friends, wherever I am going, I am telling the younger generation that they should remember five things. One, mother who has given you the beautiful birth. You should never, never forget your mother. Second, Janma Bhumi, native place where you were born. You should always remember your native place and do something to the native place, even if you become big. Third, mother tongue, the language that has come from mother's womb. You should always speak in your home, in your neighborhood, in your mother tongue only. Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayali, Punjabi, Assami, Marathi, Gujarati, whatever language, Kashmiri, Dogri, whatever language it is, Bhojpuri, you must speak in your mother tongue. Everybody should speak in mother tongue at home, because language and culture, it go together. Language and culture go together. So you have to remember that and make your children to study Tamil, to speak Tamil only at home. But unfortunately, because of foreign rule, we got the weakness of speaking other languages, ignoring our own language. That's why I always tell the younger generation, mother tongue is like eyesight. Other language is like spectacles. If you have eyesight, then your spectacle will be useful. If you don't have sight, no foresight. Even if you use reborn glasses also, you will not get proper sight. So please remember mother tongue. Always speak in mother tongue. Feel proud to speak in mother tongue. I am not against other languages. Learn as many languages as possible. Learn English also, I have no problem. Don't become English minded. This is what I am saying. There is a weakness among the society, our parents also. Even if they are not educated, they tell their children, Babu, Mummy, say Mummy, Daddy. What is this disease of Mummy, Daddy, Bidi, Jadi, Kedi? Why don't we use our language, Amma, Ma, Amma, Appa, Aya? That comes from the heart. Mummy comes from here, from the lips. Amma is so beautiful. I am not talking of Jay Kumar's Amma. That Amma is also great. Undoubtedly that Amma also is great. Unfortunately she no more. But I am talking about all of our Amma, our Ammas at home. We should respect them and we should always call Amma, Appa, Aya, like that, not the English names. This should be remembered by one and all. And then fourth one important is the motherland, the country which has given you the beautiful opportunity. India, Bharat, Hindustan, you should never, never forget it. I started liking Ma.Po.Si after reading about him because of his nationalist views. Nation first, party next, self last. That should be the approach. What is a nation? All, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one, one nation, one people, one country. That feeling should be there. And from the deeper south, Tamil Nadu, Ma.Po.Si is the one tall leader who always propagated national interest, nationalism, and he brought out the lives of people and chronicled them into a book about all great nationalists of Tamil Nadu. He brought the life of those people because to make the younger generation to remember. Unfortunately, after independence, our education system did not highlight the sacrifices made by these great people, the service they have rendered to the cause of the motherland. Only few names are there. They are no doubt they are also great people. whatever is there in Delhi. What about others? Veerapandiya Kattabomman, such a great name. V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, such a great name. Subramanya Bharati, such a great name. And you have even Satyamurthy, you have Rajagopalachari, you have Thiru Kamaraja Nadar, all great people. Anna here. And similarly, Ma.Po.Si also. I suggest that Tamil Nadu textbooks must have a lesson about Ma.Po.Si, about his contribution to the language. Not going to school, only up to second class, but writing about classical Tamil. So much addition to the literature. It's a great service he has done to the humanity. So it should be recorded. It should be part of the life, of the history of Tamil Nadu, so that the younger generation, new generation, they will also know about his great contribution. Can anybody without going to school learn literature? Can write all these important issues and learn in jail? It's not an ordinary thing. Very few examples. You have example of Thiru Kamaraja Nadar also, without education, formal education. One is second class, other is third class. But they are first class leaders. Class may be this one, first class leader, as a leaders. They were first class people. Ma.Po.Si or Thiru Kamaraja Nadar, they are first class leaders of the country. We should remember them. His political party, he had a unique way of functioning. There was the only party who conduct literary discourse on the previous day and conduct political conference on the next day morning. First day, literary discussion. What a great example he has set up. Ma.Po.Si indeed is a versatile personality who has left an indelible impression in the history of Tamil Nadu and India. His ideas, vision are as relevant today as they were when he exposed them. The need to preserve and propagate the best in our ancient literary and cultural heritage, the inclusive humanitarian approach to development, the care and the concern for the common citizens, and above all, recognizing the diversity and richness of each state with the national context are most relevant issues for each one of us even today. While there are many books about Ma.Po.Si, the one by his dedicated daughter, Madhavi Bhaskaran, titled Aringanargalin Parvayal Ma.Po.Si, is really a commendable effort to portray the person and the noble ideas and ideals he lived in by lucid and engaging style. I congratulate her, Ma, God bless you, on this great contribution for doing this service. This is not about your father. You have done this for the sake of the people of Tamil Nadu, for the children of Tamil Nadu, that they should know their grandfather, their great father, about the contribution he has made to the literature of Tamil, exposing the cause of Tamilians, highlighting the importance of Tamil leaders who are of the nationalist point of view. That is very important. I am privileged to launch this book today and dedicate it to the people of our country. This book is being dedicated to the people of our country. There are so many things we can learn from the lives of great people like Ma.Po.Si. Silambu Selvar, Dr. Ma.Po.Si has left behind a rich legacy for us. As Thiruvalluvar says, Perumai Udayavar Atruvar Atrin Arumai Udayaseyal. Great men do great deeds in a proper and perfect way. This is what Thiruvalluvar has said. The great and rare deeds of this will remain etched in our collective consciousness. They provide the inspiration for all of us to shape our lives for better. The illumine of our paths by value system that can bring greater fulfillment and harmony in our lives. The strong humanistic thread that has been spun by the great visionary leaders like Ma.Po.Si can bring diverse people together to strive for a better future. We may have different languages, we may have different castes, we may have different religions, but we are all one. We are one nation, one people, one country. That feeling has been generated by Ma.Po.Si and his writings. We are all human beings. It is unfortunate, even today after so many years of independence, there is a discrimination on the caste. Yesterday also I said, I am saying it today also. This is against the national interest. Who said which is upper caste, which is lower caste? All communities are equal. All are creatures of God. That has to be understood by all. Not allowing to enter into temple, ill-treating them on the basis of caste is against the national interest. The social change must come in. And he, Ma.Po.Si, at that time he said caste discrimination is no good. Such was the vision of that great man. We should also not discriminate against women. Women are equal partners in our development and in our life. Indian history, Hindu philosophy always gave importance to women. You go through the names of the people, gods also. Sita Rama, not Rama Sita. Radha Krishna, not Krishna Radha. You have a number of people also, names of the people. Radha Krishna, nobody has the name of Krishna Radha. First name, lady. Parvati Parameswara, you have names like Uma Maheswara, Uma Maheswara Rao. Names are there, Uma and Maheswara. Woman first. That's the tradition we have in our country. And you look into the rivers of the country, Ganga, Kaveri, Yamuna, Saraswati, Mahanadi, Narmada, Tapati, most of the names are named after women. Women were always respected by our country and by our philosophy and our ancient culture. Even the country's name is Bharata, Bharata Mata. We don't say Bharata Pita. We say Bharata Mata. That is mother. That is how we respect. We call it as motherland. Nobody calls it as fatherland. So please understand the importance of woman. We must give equal respect. We must stop discrimination on the basis of gender. Both are equal. Even the Vedic days, Upanishad days also, Gargeyi, Maitreyi, they were there in the history, arguing publicly those days. So that being the case, how can we discriminate against women? So that has to be remembered. The entire country has, we should think it like one body. Suppose you get an injury to the foot. Why should the mind think about it? Why should the eyes look at that? Why should the body bend? Why should the hand and finger go and then touch that feet? They can say mine is separate department, yours is separate department. No, because the entire body is one. Head is connected, eyes are connected, body is connected, it bends and hands goes to the leg and touches the feet. That is one body. Same thing, if something happens in Kashmir, Kanyakumari people should be worried about Kashmir. If something happens in Kanyakumari, the entire country should think that our brother and our sisters of Kanyakumari are affected. That is called as nationalism. That is called as patriotism. That is the nationalism which was exposed by Ma.Po.Si, because he was a nationalist. He was a nationalist. He was a nationalist to the core. So we should really admire, remember, propagate the teachings and preachings of such great people in order to inspire the new generation. New generation. I am sure Ma.Po.Si's family will continue their efforts to spread the invaluable message that he left behind for the entire humanity. I hope the government of Tamil Nadu and government of India will also create greatness about legends like Ma.Po.Si across the country. Nandri, Vanakkam.